Hey, Cuba Rushford Elementary, 3rd, 4th, and 5th graders, it's time for you to take the Mr. Williams Music Class Pizza Challenge.
Pizza!
The Pizza Challenge is a competition to see who can score the highest on the FlashNote Derby app.
Ooh.
What you have to do is go into FlashNote and select the lines and spaces of the treble clef, E, G, B, D, F, and F, A, C, E, and you can play on whatever level you want to, 10 questions, 20 questions, 30 questions. You can play any level you want. The more questions, the higher your score is going to be.
Wow!
Earlier, I said keep it at 10 questions. I'm changing that. It's all changed. Forget all of that. Any level you want to. There's no way I can enforce all of that. So we're going to let you play on any level, any setting you want to. Get the highest score that you can. You must take a screenshot of it and email it to me at dwilliams@mycrcs.org. And make sure you email that score to me. If you try to do it on Flipgrid, Flipgrid cuts off the scores when you send a picture of your screen. So send it to my email at dwilliams@mycrcs.org with your high score. The contest will run until June 12th. So you can keep playing and get higher and higher scores until June 12th when it ends. Every few days I will post the high scores for each grade. There will be the winner will get a personal pan pizza with your choice of a topping delivered to your house from Mr. Williams, 1 3rd grader, 1 4th grader, and 1 5th grader. So make sure you keep sending me those high scores. We'll see who comes in at the top at the end, and I will be delivering to the winners in each grade a personal pan pizza with your choice of a topping. And I think it'll be fun. So play and get your highest score. And if you play and you don't win, well, then you got to really practice your notes and you'll be an awesome note reader. So keep going and have fun playing the game.
Pizza! Pizza! Pizza!
Today, you're going to need your recorder. I'd like to work on a song, and we're going to spend the next couple of weeks looking at this song. It's a little more challenging, so I want to take some time. Today we're going to just practice the sections of this song. Next week we'll actually introduce it with the soundtrack, and it has a pretty exciting soundtrack. I think you'll enjoy it.
Okay.
But today I'd like to practice the musical parts. So let's take some time and learn these parts. I'm going to ask you to repeat them back and forth a little bit with me as we go. There's two key sections that I want you to learn before we look at all of the music on the score. So, we're going to use these recorder charts to walk through them. The first one is G, A, G, B. Would you finger that on your recorder and say it with me? G, A, G, B. Let's play it. And let's play it one more time. The second pattern is B, A, G, A. Would you say that and finger it on your recorder with me? B, A, G, A. Let's play that. Let's play it one more time. And we're going to see that pattern in this music. This song is called The Jitterbug. The Jitterbug was a dance that was really popular in the 1950s. And the music for this is in the style of that kind of dance, except that they're calling it Jitterbag because it uses the notes B-A-G. Let's look at the beginning of this piece. The first note is a G because elephants get. So let's start with our G with three fingers down. And let's say the names of the notes and finger them on your recorder. G, A is 2, B is 1, A is 2, B, A, G, and a rest. At the end of this line, there is a repeat sign. It's really hard to see it. I was running out of space, so it's a little hard to see it, but we would repeat the first line again. Let's try it again. G, A, B, A, B, A, G. Let's play it. Rest. You repeat. Now here's the first of the two patterns that we practiced a moment ago. This one is going to be 3-2-3-1, or G-A-G-B. Would you finger that for me, please? And let's play it. 3. G-A-G-B. Let's play it one more time. Here's the second pattern, B, A, G, A, 1, 2, 3, 2. Let's play that pattern. Rest, then a G, rest, then an A, rest. And then our final at the top, we have B, A, G, or bag. 1, 2, 3. Play it. And the final line is a G, A, B, and a G at the end. Let's try and play this whole piece through slowly. 1, 2, follow my fingers. Here we go. Rest. Now three fingers for G. That was our pattern. 3-1-3-2. Let's play it again. Three, two, three, one. I think I just said it wrong. 3-2-3-1. Rest, rest. And now our first finger. 1-2-3-2. Try it. Let's try that pattern one more time. Rest. And a G, 3. Rest. A. Rest. B, A, G. And then the last line, G. And next time, we'll try this with a slowed-down version of the music. But take a moment and take a screenshot of this so that you have this music and you can play it or practice it a little bit even without the screen up.
Just do it!
Thank you.